So, you have a movie for me?
Yes, sir, I do. It's called The Nightmare Before Christmas.
Oh, is that a Christmas movie or a Halloween movie?
Yes.
What?
So the movie follows this guy, Jack Skellington, in this place called Halloween Town.
And what's Jack's deal?
Well, basically, he's the Pumpkin King and he works one day a year, but he's bored of it, you know? He feels like something's missing.
And people are supposed to empathize with this guy like he's the main character?
Yeah, people love listening to privileged people complain about their privileged lives.
That's a good point. My mates love hearing me talk about wealth management problems.
Get it, that sounds amazing.
Yeah, it is.
Anyway, so one day Jack stumbles upon some doorways to all the other holidays, except those from different cultures.
Those are the weird holidays.
Yeah, super weird. So anyway, we have doorways to Thanksgiving and Valentine's Day and St. Patrick's Day.
What would be behind the St. Patrick's Day door? A bunch of drunk Bostonians wearing green?
I don't know.
What about the Thanksgiving door? Just a bunch of dead birds and potatoes?
Could be.
And what about the Valentine's Day door? Just a bunch of people drinking the blood of the innocent and eating elk hearts?
Oh, I think you're celebrating Valentine's Day wrong.
Am I?
Yeah, sure sounds that way.
It always did feel a little off. I'm gonna look into that.
Please do.
So anyway, what happens next?
Well, Jack is gonna fall through this portal thing to Christmas Town, and he's just gonna fall in love with everything he sees. He's gonna sing a song about it, too.
What kind of stuff does he sing about?
Well, like, he doesn't know what snow is, right? So he's like, what's this? There's white stuff in the air.
Oh, that's fun.
Yeah, and he's like, wow, kids are throwing snowballs instead of throwing heads.
But you just said he doesn't know what snow is.
Whoops.
Whoopsie.
So anyway, then he's gonna head back to Halloween Town.
How does he get back?
Unclear.
Wow.
But he's super pumped about Christmas now, you know? He can barely contain himself.
So what does he do?
Well, what do you do when you find something that you like, but it's not yours?
I take it.
Exactly. So Jack's gonna be like, you know what? We're doing this Christmas thing now because I enjoyed it, so it's mine now.
Oh, cultural appropriation is tight.
Yeah, and he's gonna force everybody in town to prepare for Christmas, even though nobody understands what it is, including Jack.
He's like a tyrant.
But there's this girl, Sally, that lives in Halloween Town, and she thinks it's a bad idea.
What's Sally's deal?
Well, she's kind of like a Frankenstein monster, right? She was made by this mad scientist dude.
Okay.
And we're gonna have this funny recurring thing where she keeps on trying to poison him when she makes his soup.
Oh, well, I guess if he doesn't have anyone else around to make the soup, he has to put up with it.
Well, there is a dude who calls him Master who suddenly shows up later in the movie.
So why doesn't he get him to make the soup?
I guess he really likes Sally's soup.
Fair enough. I know I'd risk dying for a good bowl of soup.
So yeah, throughout the movie, Sally's gonna be basically stalking Jack because she's in love with him.
Very romantic.
Yeah, he totally doesn't realize it. And when she does talk to him, he just ignores her.
Incredibly romantic.
And she has this premonition that his Christmas plans are gonna go super wrong.
Oh, does she have psychic abilities?
Apparently. I mean, we never bring it up before or after she talks about her vision.
Interesting.
So anyway, Jack is gonna hire these obviously evil little kids to go kidnap Santa Claus.
Rude.
And they're immediately gonna come back with the Easter Bunny instead.
Oh, so they go back and fetch Santa?
Exactly.
Wow.
Over 30 days later.
What?
So anyway, then Jack is gonna go out and deliver Christmas presents that are just horrifying and ruin everything.
Right, that definitely sounds like it would ruin Christmas.
Yeah, and so the military's gonna shoot his sleigh out of the sky and everyone in Halloween Town's gonna be like, oh no, Jack is dead.
Oh, is he dead?
Well, he was already dead.
So what are they all worried about?
That he was blown to bits.
So it's bad if he gets blown into pieces?
Well, not really, because at the beginning of the movie, he takes his own head off for a laugh.
So I don't understand what the problem is here.
Me neither. So anyway, Jack's gonna be like, I can't believe this didn't work out.
Wow, so I imagine he's really gonna have to face the music for what he did, huh?
Not at all.
Well, is he gonna have a hard time getting home now that the sleigh blew up?
No, it's gonna be super easy. Barely an inconvenience.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he's just gonna walk into the first grave he sees and that leads him home somehow.
That's super convenient. So all graves lead to Halloween Town?
Please stop asking questions about my world building.
Fair enough. So how does the movie end?
Well, Jack's gonna fight a big bag of bugs that's holding Santa captive.
Sure, that may as well happen.
And then he's gonna get the girl.
Who, Sally?
Yeah.
The girl he's been ignoring the entire movie?
Yeah, he suddenly wants her, so he takes her.
So he really hasn't learned anything or faced any consequences for his actions?
None, because of the privilege.
That does help you get away with a lot of stuff.
So what do you think of the movie?
Well, it sounds great, and if it does well, we can make a sequel.
No sequels. I don't want some cash-grabby second movie.
Oh, but cash-grabbing is tight.
Yeah, but doing a second one is just greedy, and it cheapens the first one.
All right, I gotcha. We won't do another movie.
You promise?
I promise we will not make a sequel film.
Hey guys, it's Ryan here. Thanks for watching that pitch meeting. A literal ton of these on the channel that you could check out. One ton's worth. Also, let me know in the comment section what other movies you'd like to see pitches for. And on the channel, we have some other shows like Theory Battle and some really in-depth documentaries you might like. So be sure to subscribe to the channel, like this video, maybe share it on Facebook and Twitter, and check back soon for a new pitch. Bye-bye.